Good morning and happy Sabbath. It is my really honor and privilege to be here. It is my first time to stand on a pulpit at the church in this Australia. I hope that my English will reach you.
我希望我讲的英语呢，大家能听懂。
I was a little bit worried to speak in English.
用英文布道呢，我有一点紧张。
But now I'm standing because I believe the Holy Spirit is empowering me and then has reached to you.
但是我现在站在这里啊，我希望圣灵能够给我力量，给我智慧，能够讲出上帝的道。
Okay, I would like to introduce one commercial of a Japanese fitness club.
我今天首先给大家介绍一个日本的健身俱乐部，是个商业化的健身俱乐部。
And this is a Japanese comedian.
这是一个日本的喜剧演员。
You know, the one guy, you know, looks really, you know, miserable with the very big berry, like, you know, wrong.
那些大胖子走进健身房的时候很痛苦。
And then suddenly scene changed, and then, you know, like this kind of man with a big smile.
走出来的时候就面带笑容，身材非常健美。
Yeah, appearing saying, like, commit to the result.
所以他那个姿态就彰显了这个健身房的
Many people use this service because they get result more than they expected.
越来越多的人就来到这个健身房做运动，因为他们所达到的成果比他们的期许还要好。And
there, I know that there is the God who commit the result.
那么我们也有一位上帝，他也致力于成就结果。
I'd like to read the Bible, John chapter 3, verse 16.
我们一起来读经，约翰3章16节。
You may know this is a very well-known Bible verse.
这一段圣经章节家喻户晓。
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him.
神爱世人，甚至将他的独生子赐给他们，叫一切信他的不至灭亡，反得永生。因神差他的儿子降世，不是要定世人的罪，乃是要叫世人因他得救。
Do you think Jesus commit to result?
你觉得耶稣是不是致力于成就这样的结果？
He accomplished what he promised.
他给我们的应许，他都做到了。
This God has promised us. I would like to read another John chapter 6, verse 38-14.
我现在读另外一段圣经章节，约翰6章38节。
For I have come down from heaven not to do my will, but to do the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I shall lose none of all that he has given me, but raise them up at the last day.
因为我从天上降下来，不是要按自己的意思行，乃是要按那差我来者的意思行。差我来者的意思就是，他所赐我的，叫一个也不失落，在末日却叫他复活。For
my Father's will is that everyone who looks to the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day.
因为我父的意思是叫一切见子而信的人得永生，并且在末日我要叫他复活。When
Jesus said, "I will do," then he will do.
耶稣说，我要做，他就做。
He would
他就会去做。
Today, we would like to see how God's love to each and every one of us is great through the Bible.
今天我们就看看上帝彰显在我们身上的爱是何等伟大。
I'd like to pray before we start. My prayer is from 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 10. The Heavenly Father, speak. Your servant is listening. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I'd like to read the Bible verse, the scripture reading, the read it. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 17 to 18. So that Christ may dwell in your heart through faith. And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power, together with all the saints, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ.
使基督因你们的信住在你们心里，叫你们的爱心有根有基，能以和众圣徒一同明白基督的爱是何等长阔高深。
According to the Bible, we can measure the love of God.
根据圣经章节，我们可以测量上帝对我们的爱。
The Bible says to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ.
我们可以测量耶稣基督对我们的爱是何等的长阔高深。
You cannot see love itself, right?
爱是看不见摸不着的。
Maybe you have seen love like the mark, like, you know, heart.
你可能看到爱是那个心形的形状。
But usually you don't see love itself.
但是你看不到爱，它不是一个物质。
But let's measure the love of Jesus through the Bible.
那今天早上我们就通过圣经章节来测量上帝对我们的爱。
Okay, I'm working at the Adventist Junior High School.
我在三育中学工作。
I'm a pastor, but sometimes student ask me to teach them English and math. I'm not really good at math.
我在中学里面曾经教英语跟数学，然后我数学特别棒。
But as I work in the junior high school, I would like to ask you one question.
那我在初中教书的时候，我就问孩子们一个问题。
Determine the volume of this cube.
我们要测量一下这个立方体的体积。
You know the math formula?
大家知道那个数学公式吧？
If you know the height and length and y, you can calculate the volume of this cube, right?
如果你知道这个立方体的长度、宽度、高度，那你就可以算得出来这个立方体的体积。
And the Bible verse we read said how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ.
那刚才我们读的圣经章节有在描述上帝给我们的爱是何等的长阔高深。
So maybe we may be able to know the size of the Jesus' love.
那么我们通过这个长阔高深就可以测量上帝对我们的爱。
I would like to read the several verse, Bible verse. I'm sorry, I changed in English, but maybe I'm mistaken. It was in Japanese. I'm sorry, but it says the love of the wise of the Jesus' love, Isaiah chapter 43, verse 4. So I will read it. So, okay. First, the land of Jesus' love, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 8 and 13. You know this verse.
首先我们来看耶稣的爱的长度，哥林多前书13章第八节13节。
Okay, love never fails. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
爱是永不止息。如今长存的有信、有望、有爱，这三样其中最大的是爱。
This is not the really, you know, the long length that we talk about.
这个长度还不是我们谈的这个长度。
its time period, but it shows us how long love exists.
那他,
God's love exists.
但是他告诉了我们上帝的爱可以存多久?
It says forever.
永远。
There is nothing remain forever in this world.
这世上没有什么东西是永永远远的。
Last night I talked about the worldly empire.
昨天晚上我讲了帝国的衰落。
Even the great kingdom fails, and the money, authority, everything.
甚至最伟大的帝国，历史上最强壮的帝国都也衰落了，包括金钱，包括物质，包括权力，都可能衰落。
But love of God and hope and faith remain forever.
但是信望爱是永远的。
That means, it's bigger than us, bigger than anything.
这个信望爱比我们更大，比任何事情都大。
Okay, now, heights of Jesus' love.
耶稣的爱的高度。
Isaiah chapter 55 and verse 9.
以赛亚书55章第9节。
As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts.
天怎样高过地，照样我的道路高过你们的道路，我的意念高过你们的意念。He
has a greater plan for you.
他给我们每个人准备的计划比我们想象的更伟大。You
may have your own plan.
你可能对自己有人生规划。You
may have your own idea.
你有你自己的想法。But
he has a greater one.
但是他给你的计划比你自己想象的更伟大。It's
higher than your idea, it's higher than your thought.
他的道路高过我们的道路，他的意念高过我们的意念。Now,
that goes deep, gifts of Jesus' love.
耶稣的爱的深度。First,
I will read Micah chapter 7, verse 19. You will again have a compassion on us. You will treat our sins underfoot and heart, or our iniquities into the depths of the sea.
弥迦书第七章十九节，必再怜悯我们，将我们的罪孽踏在脚下，又将我们一切的罪投于深海。One
more, Jonah chapter 2, verse 2.
约拿书二章二节。
He said, in my distress, I called to the Lord, and he answered me. From the depths of the grave, I called for help, and you listened to my cry.
说,我遭遇患难,求告耶和华,你就应允我,从阴间的深处呼求,你就俯听我的声音。His
compassion is deeper than any sea ocean in the world.
他对我们的慈爱比世上最深的海洋更深。
As you know, the highest mountain in the world is the Mount Everest.
我们知道世界上最高的山峰是珠穆朗玛峰。
But I heard that the depths of the ocean, deepest ocean, is deeper than the height of Mount Everest.
但是最深海洋的深度比珠穆朗玛峰的高度还要深。
No one can reach that.
没有人可以。 触到那个海底，那么深的海底。His
compassion is deeper than it.
他给我们的慈爱比最深的海洋还更深。You
know, I love ocean, and then, the ocean is big.
我喜欢大海，大海非常宽阔。But
his love is bigger than this world.
但是他给我们的爱比大海，比世上的一切都更大。Okay,
the size of Jesus' love, maybe wide. Isaiah chapter 43, verse 6.
耶稣的爱的大小。
Since you are precious and honored in my sight, and because I love you, I will give men in exchange for your life.
因为我看你为宝为尊，又因我爱你，所以我使人代替你，使列邦人替换你的生命。
You are precious in his eyes.
你在上帝的眼里甚为宝贵。
Therefore, he exchanged Jesus to get your life back.
所以他就甚至牺牲了独生爱子，就是为了挽回我们的生命。If
you want to buy a new car,
如果你想买一部新车,
let's say Japanese car, maybe,
比如说一部日本车。
Or Mercedes. I don't know one, which one is better. Anyway,
马自达，比如说你想买一部马自达。
Oh, I don't recommend 马自达。
我不推荐大家买马自达。
I prefer Nissan. Okay.
我喜欢尼桑车。
Anyway, yeah. If you want to buy a new car, you pay the price.
如果你想买一部新车，你就一定要给出那个价格。
Because it is the value of the car.
因为那是那部新车的价格。
God paid Jesus to buy you and me.
上帝付出他的独生爱子，就是要买回你跟我。
You know, that means your value is the same as Jesus.
那就是说你跟我在上帝眼中的价值跟耶稣对等。
Who is the creator of the universe? Who has given us a life? Who can make any miracle?
那耶稣基督在创世之初创造了宇宙万有，创造了人，然后呢，创造了各种神迹奇事。
In God's eyes, your value is the same as Jesus.
可是，在上帝眼里，你跟我的价值跟耶稣基督对等。
Isn't it amazing?
这不是很让人惊讶吗？
However, it's very simple to say that God loves us and he loves Jesus.
但是我们很容易说，我们爱上帝，就像上帝爱耶稣。
But it is very hard to know that we are not the worthy people.
但是很难说服自己说我们值得上帝的爱。
Because we are all sinners.
因为我们是罪人，所以事实上我们不配得上帝的爱。
Sin is the problem that all of us have.
罪是有史以来就一直都有的。
You may say that I'm not a criminal.
你可能说我又不是犯罪分子。
Maybe I have done something, you know, bad. But compared to others, you know, my attitude is not so serious.
我可能犯过一些小错误，做过一些错事，可是也没有什么太严重的大问题。
Yes, we are not a criminal.
我们不是犯罪分子。
And even if we, you know, have committed something bad, it may be small things, small problems.
就算是我做错了一些事情，也没啥大不了的。
But these small things cause a serious big problem.
但是一些小错误往往有严重的后果。
What is the center of the sin?
罪的核心是什么？
You know, the sin. I've learned that the English sin, the center character is I.
Sin, S-I-N, 中间的那个字母是 I.
So sin is the self-centered mind.
罪呢，就是以自我为中心。
Selfishness.
自私。
Going my way.
以我的方式进行。
I.
我是中心。
These are the center idea of the sin.
这种以自我的价值为中心就是罪的核心。
And I heard from my friend, he's teaching Chinese character kanji.
我的朋友呢教那个中国字。
This Chinese character was like, the image was like, you know, two person.You know, turn back each other.
这个汉字的这个造型呢，就好像两个人背靠背翻脸了。
So that means we turn, you know, face back to the God, from God.
那我们背向上帝，掩面不看上帝，这个就是罪的原始。
If I'm okay, that's okay.
如果我 OK, 其他所有都 OK.
I want to do this and I want that way.
我想做这件事，我要这么做。
And always I.
所有事情的核心都是我。
We are living now the age, the generation of I.
现在这个时代就是自我为中心的时代。
iPhone.
iPod. iPhone, iPod.
iTunes.
iTunes.
iBook, everything I.
所有这个人工智能化的时代，所有一切都是以自我为中心。
It may be inference to us that we always concern I.
我们考虑的首先考虑的总是我自己。
That is the problem of a sin.
这个就是罪的核心问题。
There is one example.
我给出大家一个例子。
One girl started smoking when she was 16 years old.
一个女孩十六岁的时候开始学抽烟。
Because her friend, bad friends asked her to join them.
因为她交了一些坏朋友，把她带坏了。
Parents found her, you know, this bad attitude and punish her and tell her don't do it.
那她父母就想管教她，说你不要养成这个坏习惯。
And you know, she said to the parents, "Why you are taking it so serious? It's just smoking."
那他就对父母说，你至于这么小题大做吗？我不也就是抽烟而已吗
you know, ？I can stop smoking anytime I want.
我想戒烟，我立刻就能戒。
But you know, parents know the addicted people of the cigarette.
但是父母亲知道，如果一旦抽烟上瘾是很难戒的。
So they strongly recommend her to stop it.
所以父母就强力管教他，让他不要抽烟。
I used to be a heavy smoker too.
我之前抽烟也抽得很厉害。
So I know this is serious, but she didn't realize it is serious.
那我知道这个问题有多严重，可是这个女孩不知道。
She didn't like what the parents says to her.
她不喜欢父母的管教。
So one day, she decided to leave from their house.
所以她决定离家出走。
She left home that night.
她晚上就走了。
And went so far from their parents.
她越走越远。
And she met the man who was very kind to her.
她就碰上一个对她特别好的男人。
Started to live in together with him.
就开始同居。
And working at the bar.
那在酒吧工作。
Get some money.
赚一些零钱。
Made a lot of friends.
交了很多朋友。
She thought this is the happy life.
她觉得这很快乐。
But one day, a man asked her to take a drug.
但是那个人就男人就告诉她，让教她怎么吸毒。
She thought she can handle it.
她觉得这也没什么大不了的。
So she used.
所以她就开始吸毒。
And after that, she could not control herself.
这下她就彻底失控了。
Lost the money.
啊，她啊亏了钱。
Lost the job.
啊，丢了工作。
Lost friends.
啊，也没了朋友。
Lost house.
啊，她的房子也没了。
Lost herself.
她自己也失落了。
Everyone left.
啊，她失去了她所有的一切。
She was just miserable.
她变得越来越痛苦。
Her beautiful face turned to, you know, dirty face.
她本来挺漂亮的一张脸也变得很扭曲。
Because of the drug.
啊，因为吸毒之后就变得。
She didn't have money, so she couldn't eat. So she lost almost 10 kilos of weight.
她甚至没钱吃饭啊，最后体重也下降了十公斤。
But no one wants to give her help.
但是那时候没有人就是出手相助了。
She was alone.
啊，她很孤独。
You know, one simple small sin can be the cause of the big problem.
一个小小的失误可能会引发很大的问题。
Same thing happened at the beginning of this world.
啊，这个创世之初也有类似的问题。
Genesis chapter 2 verse 16 to 17 says.
创世纪。
Genesis chapter 2 verse 16, 17 says.And the Lord God commanded to the man, You are free to eat from any tree in the garden, but you must not eat from the tree of the knowledge of the good and evil. For when you eat of it, you will surely die.
启示录，创世纪二章十六十七节，耶和华神吩咐他说，园中各样树上的果子你可以随意吃，只是分别善恶树上的果子你不可吃，因为你吃的日子必定死。
God said, don't eat it.
上帝说你不要吃。
You have thousands of choice in the Garden of Eden.
园子里有成千上万的果实你都可以吃。
But only this one.
只有这棵树上的果子。
If you eat it, you will surely die. So don't eat it.
只有这棵树上的果实，你如果吃，你必定死，所以你不要吃。
If you have a child and if this child do something dangerous, what would you do?
如果你的有个小孩，然后这孩子有危险行为，你要怎么做呢？
You will surely say, "Don't do it."
你当然说教育，你会教育孩子不要这么做。
And God created so many other options.
上帝给了你成千上万的选择。
I don't know how many fruits.Or vegetable in this world.
这世上有多少水果，有多少蔬菜，简直数不胜数。
There are so many options in this world.
这世上有这么多的选择。
You know, God provided their food.
上帝给了我们足够的蔬菜水果做我们的食物。
Maybe thousand or more than thousand.
成千上万。
God prohibited only one.
上帝禁止的这个禁果只有一个而已。
But what human did is, it is written in chapter 3, verse 6.
启示录三章第六节，看看我人类是怎么做的。
When the woman saw that the fruit of the tree was good for food, and pleasing to the eye, and also desirable for gaining wisdom, she took some and then ate it.
于是女人看见那棵树上的果子好做食物。也悦人的眼目，却是可喜爱的，能使人有又有智慧，就摘下来吃了。
You know, here we can see I problem.
这里就看到这个以自我为中心的问题了。
I want to eat it.
我想吃这个果子。
I like it.
我喜欢这个果子。
I decide.
我决定。
I.
我。
Broke the promise between human and God.
就打碎了上帝跟人类的这个应许。
And the result was the death.
那罪的工价乃是死。
Sin started even before this happened and this world was created.
事实上在创世之前罪就开始了。
Lucifer, who is the head of the angel, was the cause of the sin.
路西弗那个时候是天使长，他是罪的起源。
He was a special angel.
他非常与众不同。
He was wiser than any other angel.
他比别的天使更聪明。
I believe all angels respect him.
那所有的其他天使就很敬仰他。
This perfect angel jealous to Jesus Christ.
这个完美的受造之物呢，就很嫉妒耶稣基督。
He wants to become God.
他也想变成上帝。
He wants to be a number one.
他想成为第一。
Inside of him always I.
在他的心里都是我。
So he started jealous.
所以他变得很嫉妒。
The jealous made the world trouble.
那嫉妒就是这个世界上所有的磨难的开始。
Death, war, sickness.
死亡、战争、疾病等等。
You know, envy.
嫉妒。
So, and we all has this kind of a sin.
我们都有这样类似的罪。
This sin made the most beautiful angel turn to devil.
那么就是这样的罪将美丽的天使变成了魔鬼。
This sin caused death, pain of birth, and suffering.
那这样的罪引发了死亡怀胎的苦楚。
So we cannot surely say we are worthy to be loved by God.
所以我们不能说我们这样的罪人配得上帝的爱。
Because we are this kind of a people. We are not worthy.
我们就是这么堕落，我们不配上帝的爱。
For the wages of sin is death.
因为罪的工价乃是死。
Okay, yeah. For the wage of the sin is the death. It is written in Romans chapter 6, verse 23.
罗马书六章二十三节，罪的工价乃是死。
But here is the hope.That Jesus gave us.
但是耶稣给了我们希望。
Says because love covers over a multitude of sins.
彼得一书四章八节，因为爱会遮盖许多的罪。
There's an old story in Japan.
在日本有一个古老的故事。
One Japanese samurai robbery.
有一个日本的武道士 robbery.
You know, he sometimes, you know, he.Attacked the people, he ambushed.
有的时候他埋伏在什么地方来攻击人。
And he steal the money.
他偷钱。
He steal the clothes.
他偷衣服。
Sometimes he killed the people.
有的时候他还杀人。
But her daughter, who is very gentle and kind.
但是他女儿很温柔，很有爱心。
Always ask him, please, father, don't do this.
那他女儿就是很善良，就一直。求他父亲说 你不要这么做。
You are doing something wrong.
你这个是不对的。
But father never listened.
但是他父亲从来不听他的。
One day,
有一天
as usual, he was waiting for someone to come.
所以他这个强盗的武道士呢，有一天就等着有人走过来。
With you know the sharp Japanese sword.
那个带了一颗很锋利的日本的剑。
And he saw the woman, wearing a very nice, seems expensive clothes, and with the umbrella.
然后他就看到一个女生，就是穿得很高档，然后拿着一个伞就走过来。
So he shout and then appear and then said, "Give me your money."
所以他就跳出来就大喊一声说，你给我你的钱。
She ran away.
那这个女生就跑了。
So he killed her.
他就把这个女的就杀了。
And he took her wallet.
他就偷了她的钱包。
And opened it.
就打开。
There's no money.
那钱包里面居然没有钱。
Just one single paper.
就只有一个纸条。
It is written, "Father, please stop do this."
那上面写的说，父亲呐，你不要这么做。
I give my life, so please.
我为着你的行为付出了我的生命。
Because I love you, I will beg you this.
因为我爱你，我求你不要这么做。
He realized that what he has done kills her, his daughter.
所以他发现说，这个盛装打扮的这个走过来的这个女生呢，事实上是他女儿。
It may be a weird story for you.
你可能觉得这个故事有点奇怪。
But this story tells us, you know, that no one could change him.
那这个故事也跟我们讲述了一下，就说没有人可以改变这个人。
But his daughter's love sacrifice changed his life.
但是他女儿对他的爱，他的牺牲改变了他的这个人。
He never did the same thing again.
他之后再也不这么做了。
You know, as I showed the one Japanese comedian lost a lot of weight in the beginning.
我在讲到的开始的时候，给大家看了这个日本的一个喜剧演员，非常胖。
You know, he did a lot of exercise.
然后他很努力的锻炼健身。
And he realized how much weight he lost shows how much you suffer to lose.
他所有这个砍下去的这个体重，就是他砍下去的痛苦。
If it is a small, then you say, "Okay, I can handle it."
如果你犯了一个小错误，你可能觉得这也无所谓啊。
But if it is a serious, we cannot do anything.
但是如果是很严重的问题，我们就一点没办法。
And I myself, when I realized how much I'm sinful, then I realized how much greater and the love of Jesus is bigger than I thought.
所以我越知道自己多么罪孽深重，我就越体会到上帝给我们的爱是何等伟大。
You know, there is two sinners.
有两个罪人。
One is the criminal who was crucified on the cross beside the Jesus cross.
在耶稣被钉死在十字架的时候，他左边右边有两个罪人。
You know, his life was also miserable.
他的生命其实也很痛苦。
He just wanted to have a better life.
他希望有好一点的生活。
But he wasn't able to have.
但是他就没有。
So he did the many mistakes.
他就做错了很多事。
And finally he was caught.
最后呢，就这是结局。
And now the end of his life.
在他生命即将结束的时候
，He regretted his life.
他遗憾，他忏悔。
And he hated the people around him.
他很憎恨他边上的那些人。
And when he looked at this side, he saw a man, the man.
所以他这边转身一看，他边上看到了这个人。
He's different with others.
这个人跟其他人不一样。
Because he heard the prayer like.Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing.
因为他边上这个被钉在十字架上的人说，父啊，原谅他们，因为他们所做的，他们自己不知道。
He never heard this kind of prayer on the cross.
他 从来没有听到过这样的，就是在十字架上这样的祷告。
Usually he heard, you know, any bad words, you know, regret words.
他通常听到的都是那些，遗憾呐、啊、忏悔呀、啊、这样的祷告词。
But this man is a different.
但是这个人的祷告与众不同。
He prayed for others.
他为别人祷告。
He prayed the people who hang him out.
他甚至为把他挂在十字架上的人祷告。
And his eyes, he saw the love.
他在他的眼里看到了爱。
So he asked to the man.
所以他就问边上的这个人。
Please remember me.
请你记得我。
And the man replied.
然后中间的这个人就说。
I tell you the truth.
我实话告诉你。
Today you will be with me in the paradise.
今夜你就与我同在乐园了。
There is another sinner. One more.
另外一边还有一个罪人。
It's not the man who was on the cross.
不是挂在十字架上的。
He was just a hopeless man.
他是一个完全没有希望的罪人。
No dream, no hope.
没有梦想，没有希望。
Always hate others.
他对人充满了恨。
Always think about, you know, I want to become number one.
他总是想说，我要成为世界第一。
Always fight with others.
总是跟人斗。
Bad habit.
有很多恶习。
Smoking, drinking, sometimes maybe have a drug.
抽烟、喝酒、吸毒。
But when he seeks something that you can put in your heart and feel and become a foundation of a life.
但是他也觉得他的生命可以填充一些什么样的东西，成为他生命的基石。
Many people prayed for him.
很多人就为他祷告。
And he became a pastor.
他就变成了牧师。
Because he met Jesus Christ.
因为他遇上了耶稣基督。
When he seek something greater than him.
他在寻求比他更伟大的一样东西的时候，他寻到了耶稣。
And now he's standing in front of you.
现在这个牧师就站在大家的面前。
I couldn't stop smoking.
我那时候怎么都戒不了烟。
But God's grace, I was able to stop it.
但是上帝的恩典令到我可以就戒
烟了。I always hate people.
我那时候对人充满了恨。
Because I thought everyone doesn't like me. Everyone don't like me.
我那时候觉得每个人都不喜欢我。
I always want people to, you know, recognize as a strong man.
我总是想成为最强壮的人。
But I failed always.
但是我都失败了。
So one day I prayed.
那有一天我就祷告。
If I say in Japanese more direct, but I pray like, Lord, if you are here, try to do something.
我就祷告说，上帝啊，如果你真的存在的话，那你就有所作为，改变我。
Prove me that you are here.
你证向我证明你真的有在存在。
And I said, you are not the God.
那我说你不是上帝。
And he responded after 5 minutes.
他五分钟以后就回应了我的祷告。
He showed me a very miraculous things to me.
他马上就给我看了一个神迹。
And I said to God, Lord, I give up.
那我就说，上帝啊，我屈服，我顺服你。
Now I know that you are God.
我知道你是又真又活的神。
You know, if we notice that how sinful we are, we also know through the Bible that how great God's love is.
如果我们意识到我自己有多么罪孽深重，你就更知道说上帝的爱有多么的长阔高深。
The Holy Spirit teach you how sinful you are.
圣灵会引导我们知道说我们的罪。
How selfish you are.
我们有多自私。
It is very hard to accept.
但是你很难接受这样的概念。
But also, he will teach us how much Jesus loves this sinner.
那圣灵也会引导我们，让我们知道上帝是如此的爱这样的罪人。
He died for you who are not worthy to be loved.
我们甚至不配上帝的爱，可是他仍然为我们而死。
I pray that today, the Holy Spirit will touch you.
我今天希望啊，圣灵都有触摸我们的心灵。
Now, you know, teach you how sinful and selfish you are.
让我们知道我们自己有多么的罪孽深重。
And we feel hopeless and then regret ourselves.
啊，然后我们在绝望，在放弃自己的时候。
As his Jesus' disciple fell.
啊，就像耶稣的使徒那个时候也要放弃了。
But when we look at the Bible,
但是他读经的时候
he will show you the love of the good Jesus.
啊，会让我们看到耶稣基督的爱。
I pray that today you will decide to accept Jesus' love.
我祷告，希望今天我们都在这里也接受耶稣基督给我们的爱。
And ask him to change your life.
啊，求耶稣基督改变我们的生命。
I don't care if you are Christian or non-Christian.
我不介意你是基督徒还是不是基督徒。
Even if you are Christian and Adventist, ask him to change your life.
如果你是基督徒，如果你是啊复临基督徒啊，求上帝改变你的生命。
If you don't know Jesus yet, please accept him because he is calling you.
如果你还不认识耶稣基督，你也接受他，因为他在呼召你。
If you answer to him,
如果你回应耶稣
，result is much bigger than what happened to my life.
他对你生命的改造是远远超过你能想象得到的。
You know, he is the God commit to result.
因为我们的上帝是成就于结果的上帝。
If you want him to change your life, he will change your life.More than you expected.
如果你给上帝机会来改变你的生命，他给你重新塑造的人生之路远远比你想象的更好。
Let us pray and ask His Holy Spirit to touch our heart and teach us how sinful we are, and moreover that how Jesus loves you anyway.
我们一起做个祷告，让圣灵带领我们，让我们知道我们是罪人，请圣灵。请上帝来带领我们的人生。
Heavenly Father, thank you for your promise. And thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, I pray that the Holy Spirit will touch our heart and we may be able to respond to you and we accept you as our Savior. Lord, I pray thatThe people here will accept you so that from now on our life will be changed. Change to the life you prepared for each and every one of us. Lord, thank you for your Son Jesus Christ once again. Thank you for what you have done to our life. Thank you for guiding us.Thank you for your love. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. May God bless you all.